the Director General of Civil Aviation, or the DGCA, says it has extended deadline for the Indigo to replace all unmodified Pratt and Whitney engines from 31st January to May 31st. So the aviation regulator there extending the deadline to replace the faulty engines. It has been extended by 5 months. Let me go across to my colleague Neha, who's joining me on the phone line. Neha, at a time where we're looking at several Indigo and Go Air aircrafts coming up with problems in the engine because of Pratt and Whitney, why is there an extension being given of 5 months?
Definitely, this comes as a major important news as far as the understanding of the replacement of engines, the Pratt & Whitney engines, which have been showing a lot of technical snags in Go Air and Indigo flight is concerned. We remember, Apurva, that before this, the DGCA had said that they are trying to give the airlines time to be able to speak to Pratt & Whitney and get the remodified engines in place at the earliest. And we understand now that the deadline has been almost extended by 4 months. Which is mainly to give this particular airline more time to get. And remember that this is not the first time the regulatory body has pushed the deadline. Even before last year, we saw that they were asked to replace them about 19 engines before, for which no clarity was given from the airline whether that replacement was done or no. And now, yet again, the airline has been given more 4 months to have replaced about 97 of their engines, which are of Pratt and Whitney make. So definitely, this sends a big message out there to all the passengers who are flying with the airline, considering now more time has been given to the airline for the replacement of the engines. And there is no clarity yet from the airline as to whether the current aircraft which is flying are with modified engines or not.
Absolutely. So that clarity is not coming in at this point. But also, Neha, if you can give us some numbers on how many aircrafts are currently flying with the A Neo 320 with the Pratt & Whitney engine, which are still flying in both Go Air and Indigo.
We understand that Indigo, which has the largest market share as far as the Indian airline space is concerned, they are flying with up to 130 aircraft, and they have about 97 of their engines, which are of Pratt & Whitney make. Apart from that, Go Air is the second airline in India that largely runs with A320 new aircraft, which require these Pratt & Whitney engines. Now, last time what they had promised DGCA is that by January 31, they will be able to replace about 16 of their engines, which are of Pratt & Whitney make. But we understand that according to the statement that was given by the aviation minister in the parliament, he had said that about more than 100 engines in total are required to be replaced from Pratt & Whitney that requires replacement at the earliest. So we understand that while this deadline has now been extended to 4 months, the information that has been given to Indigo is that they have to replace the engines of Pratt & Whitney make by May 31 now.
All right, Neha, I request you to stay with us at this point because it is very important at this juncture to understand whether this particular extension is really justified at a time. Let me go across to Mr. Vipul Saxena, aviation expert, who's also joining us on this broadcast. Mr. Saxena, good afternoon. We would like to understand from you. In the past, we have in fact spoken about several instances of engine problems because of Pratt & Whitney, which has been identified time and again. Do you feel that this extension of another 5 months is really justified to go ahead and even compromise with passenger safety? Is this 5 month extension justified?
Firstly, I would say that this is a very unfortunate extension if it is being given. But nevertheless, I am yet to know on what technical basis this extension has been given. I am sure unless they are given some kind of discounting in terms of carrying passengers or payloads or flight time, some kind of restrictions, if they are put in, then I think it can be a balanced decision taken technically and commercially. But yes, bottom line is that it is an unfortunate extension.
All right, so we do believe that perhaps it is the need of the hour for both Indigo and Go Air to replace all the unmodified Pratt & Whitney engines. But if we talk about on the part of both these airlines, be it Go Air or Indigo, according to you, what are the concerns because of which there is a certain delay when it comes to both these airlines replacing the unmodified Pratt & Whitney engines?
See, so many engines changing, so many engines, in such a short time. I feel there may be some problem with the Pratt & Whitney to provide that kind of support. So probably considering that, this extension must have been considered. But yes, the way DGCA is working these days, they are taking very pragmatic decisions. So I'm sure they must have done some kind of technical evaluation, and they must have also imposed some kind of restriction on the flying operations, probably in terms of the payload or in terms of the flight timings, something like that. I'm sure some study must have been done. But yes, overall, I would be happy as a air safety, concerned person that this should have been avoided.
But then in that case, Mr. Saxena, while there is an extension that has been given, do you agree that perhaps the DGCA should also bring in more measures to perhaps ground certain aircrafts with Pratt & Whitney? Because even as we speak, for the next 5 months, perhaps you're looking at these Pratt & Whitney engine A Neo 320s that will still be flying, and that is going to compromise on passenger safety. So do you think that perhaps more needs to be done in addition to perhaps giving an extension for 5 months to replace the unmodified engines?
See, I think we would need to wait for the details to come out that what kind of study or what, okay, on what basis DGCA has taken the decision. But apparently for last two years, since this new team of Mr. Puri as a minister and Mr. Arun Kumar as a DGC has come, things are moving quite a,
all right,
strict compliances and technical studies are being done. So we'll have to wait to get to know the details on what basis they have given this extension. I'm sure they must have done the due diligence before giving this extension.
All right, we'll have to leave it there. Appreciate you joining us, Mr. Vipul Saxena, with your views on this, and also to my colleague Neha for joining us with those updates.